Welcome back everyone, Ronin here. Today I'm going to show you my stats guide for Divinity Original Sin. At this point, I'm nearing the end of the game. I'm not maxed out, I'm not right at the end just yet. If I feel like I have more things to show, this will give me room to be able to show a few pulls without actually getting to the end of the game. There's only a limited amount of encounters in this game, so I didn't want to push it too far. I put the settings on normal to be able to show the stats properly. I'm level 17, so I think 22, 23 may be like the very max level you can reach. So I'm going to talk about stats. Now, strength, dexterity, intelligence, constitution, speed, and perception. Those are your main stats. Strength will affect your chance to hit. It doesn't increase damage, just your chance to hit. Same goes with dexterity. Now, the only difference between these two is the type of weapon you're going to use and the skill sets tied to those stats. Strength is mainly for your fighters, knights, warriors, and it's tied to the man-at-arm skills. The dexterity is tied to the scoundrel and marksman skill tree or skill sets, and it generally goes with daggers, rapiers, the finesse type weapons. Any weapon that you basically backstab with or shoot from range, like a bow or crossbow. Intelligence. Intelligence is the only one stat that will actually increase your damage. As far as I know, you can't crit with a spell, so it's just all about the straight damage and the chance to cause certain effects. If you look at bloodletting right now, it has 150% chance to set bleeding status. So that's a 60% increase because of my current int level. For blind, it's 150% chance to set the blind status. This comes into play with the enemy's resistance. If they're resistant to blind, the higher the percentage, the least likely it is to miss or not apply the status effect, depending on your enemy's resistance and their dice roll to save from those debuffs. Constitution affects how much health you have, but also your amount of action points that you do get. So this comes into play heavily if you click the Glass Canon talent. This will really change how many action points you will get per turn. Speed. For every 2 points on the odd number, it will give you an extra action point per turn. This also comes heavily into effect when you factor in the Glass Canon talent. I have 3 characters with the Glass Cannon talent, and that's just for maximum damage and crowd control ability. Perception is there for your critical hit chance, initiative, starting action points, your ability to detect traps, and accuracy when shooting from long distances. So this is really good if you plan on playing a ranger class or even a rogue class. Sight and hearing are not really that important. I've never actually stacked these. This is just what you get from building your character. I don't see it being anything really that important. I mean, you're not going to outrange this stat because the base is 18.5. So unless you're wearing a lot of gear that reduces your sight range, I guess the only time would be a ranger, because a bow can actually shoot quite far. I don't know if I have one on this character. So 26 meters. So yeah, maybe the ranger would have to get something done about its sight range. But that's still really far into combat. Right now, this character gets 17 for most spells. So 17 is... So I wouldn't be too worried about it. Damage, that would be your physical damage, so hitting with your melee weapon. Armor rating, I'm not too worried about that. In theory, you shouldn't get hit too much. Your goal is to avoid as much damage as possible through crowd control. This should only be focused on for early in the game if you're playing a melee type fighter, because you will take a few hits. Towards the end of the game, you should pretty much not get hit at all. Blocking only works if you have a shield. Critical hit chance. I'm pretty sure casters can't crit, so this only takes an effect for physical damage. Your offense rating, it's your chance of hitting an enemy. Now, with spells, you pretty much will hit every single time. I don't think spells can miss, I could be wrong, but here it says that I got bonus 120 from my intelligence. So I've not yet seen a spell miss unless it's just a status effect. So if we're talking about, teleport can't miss. We're talking about head vice, where 95% chance to set the blind status. Defense rating, that is to avoid an attack, and I think that comes from dexterity. So your defense rating comes from dexterity. Now I'm at base 5, so there's no increase here. If I show you my rogue, rogue has a bonus 35 from more dexterity. So it looks about 5 points per, because I have 7 points added. So plus 5 to your evasion rating per point. Vitality is your hit points. If you reach 0 with this, you will die. Your character will die and you will need to use a resurrection scroll or spell to bring it back to life. Death is semi-permanent in this game, meaning that you won't get up on any other condition than a resurrection spell. Action points. This is kind of important. You want to plan your build a little bit around your action points. Now, I knew I was going in with Glass Canon, which doubles your action points at the cost of 50% of your life. So right now I should have 1400 health essentially. I lost, 50% is gone after all the boosts. So it's a big decrease in health. So you want to make sure you know what you're doing if you're planning on using the Glass Cannon skill. Now, it says here my maximum action points are 17, and that's basically a combination of my base, which is 7. For my constitution, and plus 10 from constitution. So basically, your maximum action points are 100% related to your constitution, which is why you want to figure out the number that works for you. For me, it was 9, but I ended up getting more gear that added higher than 9. So 16 was my number for me. So 14 should have been my number. 7 would have been my number for constitution. The only issue is I got gear that added more constitution, so I just added on anyway. Which means that I can pass a turn or end a turn with one or two action points left, and it'll just carry over to the next turn, which is not a bad thing. Your start action points is directly linked to your speed and perception. So here I have plus 5. So when I start my turn, I only get 7 action points, which is generally enough for one cast, or maybe get into position for the next turn. But on your first turn, you definitely want to get some type of crowd control going, so that you don't get hit and you can live for the rest of the fight, essentially. Reputation is how people feel about you, their attitude towards you. I don't do really anything with that. It's not an important combat stat or anything. This may come into play if you're doing quests. Now, your resistances. You have fire, water, earth, air, tenebrium, and poison. If you manage to get these above 100, maybe my tank? No. So, let's just show you real quick. So, if you manage to get your stat above 100, you will start absorbing that element. I gotta be quick about it. My knight will have fire, earth. Okay. So, if I do fire damage on my knight, it will actually absorb the damage. Oh well, gotta be careful with this because your character can leave. Okay, so 4. See, now I healed. So this comes into handy if you're trying to build yourself a tank character or any character really that you don't want to get hit from spells or die from spells. So any damage above or any percentage above 100, you will start absorbing that damage. This is really handy. I think some shields are pretty good in the resistance department. So it's really easy for a tank class to go above 100 and be immune to almost all spell damage. Now as a caster, it's fairly low, but yeah, tanks, sometimes rogues have some good resistances also. So this covers the stats on the main screen. Now your abilities, these are how you're going to build your character. I'm going to get into those more as I talk about individual characters. A few to note. Here you're going to have leadership. You want to have at least one, preferably two characters that will stack leadership. And the reason for this, here I have 4, is it boosts the rest of the group. doesn't boost a character that has the leadership perk. So you also want that person to get. I mean, it's really, they're really good bonuses. So the bonuses you get, it's plus 10 initiative, 10 chance to hit, 10 or 15 damage, and 1 crit chance. I mean, those are pretty big increases. Thank you all for watching. I'm going to stop the video here and create my class guides. I'm going to make one for Mage, Knight, and Rogue. This will give you an idea of how to build your characters and have an effective group, essentially. So thank you all for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.